Again, welcome everyone to this live. I am here to talk a little bit more about, I think this is episode 172 of the More Than Your Weight podcast. If you have not subscribed or listened to any of my podcasts so far, it's time to do so. A lot of great stuff coming up over the summer and in the fall. And obviously there's over 172 regular episodes, plus I think 11 or 12 essential oil bonus episodes that you can go and listen to now. So nearly 200 episodes you can go back and listen to. But today I wanted to talk a little bit about one core thing that I mentioned in this week's podcast. This week's podcast is episode 172. It is when you're tired of feeling sick and tired. When you're sick and tired of feeling sick and tired. And this just came out of just the constant things I was hearing from clients who started working with me or even in my audience. Just like when women are finally sick and tired of feeling sick and tired, that's when change is possible. But and it's just like with any change. And if you even think about people like who have struggled with certain things for a long while, things that we may consider more serious things like different addictions and all that, they have to come to a point where they're aware, but they're done with it. And it's the same thing when it comes to your health. You have to come to a point where you're just tired of feeling sick and tired, and you're tired of just going about things as normal and things not changing. And so in this week's podcast, I talk about three questions to ask yourself when you're tired of feeling sick and tired. Is one, really figuring out what's the cause, like what's causing you internally or externally to feel sick and tired. What I mean by internally, it's like what things are you contributing to that's making you feel sick and tired? Maybe you're not sleeping, maybe you're not eating as well, all that. But what things are you set up in your environment that are not conducive to you feeling energetic, feeling healthy and vibrant and alive? Then the second question is, what have you tried in the past that has worked, that has helped you to stop feeling sick and tired? And what has worked and what hasn't worked? Because that's just very key, because we want to continue to do the things that work rather than going back to the things that don't work. And that, I see this so often when it comes to women trying to lose weight, when to manage their weight, overcome overeating, manage their cravings, feel good in their body again, get in all these healthy habits, is that they're constantly trying to go back to things that don't work. And you might not recognize that it's things that don't work, because often if you're trying to do a quick fix program, if that hasn't worked for you in the past over the long haul and it being sustainable, it's not going to work for you again. It's just a new name. A lot of diets are a new name to the same game, right? So we want to figure out what has worked before and continue to do that. Now, the third question I ask, which is I'm going to highlight a little bit more on this live, is figuring out what do you need to move forward? What do you need to stop feeling sick and tired? And I mentioned a couple of things such as coaching, such as accountability and clarity and all these different things. And I want to talk about three ingredients right now that you need to move forward from feeling sick and tired. And the reason why I want to highlight a little bit on what we need, focusing on what we need, is because often many of us as women either know what we need but aren't prioritizing, or don't actually know what we need. You just know you need a change, but you don't know what's going to help you make that change. And so the three ingredients to figuring out what you need when you're done feeling sick and tired is clarity, simplicity, and accountability. And I want to talk a little bit more about that. And I'm going to say this really briefly because my little girl is fighting her nap really hard. So clarity. So often we don't really know what we need. I have a coach for my business. I have a coach in multiple areas of my life. And often I come to my session saying like, this is what I need. And as we're talking, I realize that's not actually what I need. I'm not quite clear on what I need. Often I think it's a strategy. And I think it's the same way when it comes to our health. I need to do this. I need to talk with these people. I need to do this. But most often it's a mindset issue. Like, oh, I don't believe this is possible. Or I'm just tired, or all of these different things. And so figuring out what we need and getting very clear on that is very key. And this is things that I love to support clients in, because often clients even come to my session saying, hey, I want to work on this. And as I ask some questions, they get clear. I get clear. That's actually really not what they want to work on, or that's not really the problem, right? So clarity is very key to figuring out what you need. Like, what do you actually need, and getting very clear about that? Because you may think, oh, I just need to start exercising again, when in reality, you may need to start sleeping. Oh, I just need to stop drinking as much coffee, which may be true, but maybe you just need to reduce your cortisol levels and reduce stress, and therefore you're not running to caffeine as much, whatever, right? So getting clear on what you really need is important. Two, making it simple. And I think I talked, when did I talk about this? I might've talked about this in a recent podcast. No, I talked about this in one of the lives last week on the Food and Body Reset here in the group. I think it's talking about healthy habits and just the idea of like, when we're starting a new habit, we want to just have this new overhaul program because we think we're all or nothing, or we think doing a massive change is what's going to get us there. But really it's simple things. And some of the ways to do that is like, if it takes you 2 minutes to do it. And so I even talked about this last week. If you just start with 2 minutes of exercise a day or 5 minutes or 10 minutes, just really start small and make things super simple for yourself. And so if you're like, you know what? I know that I don't have a good relationship with food. I feel bad every time I eat a certain food, or I plan all my meals and for some reason I don't eat those meals at home. So how can you make that more simple for yourself? Maybe you're like, I'm just going to try to cook one meal home a week, then figure out some healthy options outside the house. Rather than thinking and just trying to make it all complicated for yourself and trying to cook every day, like, come on, I don't cook every day, and which is fine. And if you cook every day, that's fine. But what I'm trying to say is start small and make things simple. So simplicity is one thing I love to help clients with as well, because for me, guess what, sweet friend, I did not lose 30 pounds, 40 pounds, I can't forget how much, and sustain that weight loss for 7 years until having my daughter and getting pregnant by doing complicated things. I did that by doing simple, simple things and just adding to those simple steps and habits daily, weekly, monthly, quarterly, yearly, right? And I would love to support you in that. And then the third thing is accountability. So I know for me, I actually have the potential to do a lot of things. Like I can do a lot of things at one time, maybe not as much with this crying infant over here or toddler. I don't know. What do you consider a 1 year old? But I now need to be accountable and doing less. I need to be more accountable and doing things more simple. But also there are goals I still have for myself that sometimes, some days I'm like, I don't really want to work out because I'm just tired. I've been watching a kid. I've been trying to run a business, been trying to take care of a household. And then I just, okay, I'm like, well, I have told my husband or told someone that I want to work out 4 times a week. So I'm holding myself, I have someone holding me accountable, and not a smash it over your head if you're doing it wrong sort of way, in a way that like, no, like, this is good for me, and having someone to coach me, guide me, hold me accountable is very, very helpful. So I think clarity, simplicity, and accountability are three ingredients that you need to really move forward when you're done feeling sick and tired. So I want to ask you, clarity, accountability, simplicity, which one of those do you really need right now? I think you need all three, but which one of those do you really need right now? And how are you going to get that? Is it clarity? Is it like, I actually don't know what to do to really stop feeling sick and tired? I don't know what to do to reach my health goals for the long haul and sustainably. Then what are you going to do to get clear? Are you going to journal? Are you going to think through what's worked in the past? Are you going to reach out to a coach? What are you going to do? And then simplicity. Okay, maybe you're like, you know what? I've tried all this before, but if I can make this a little bit more simple, this will be sustainable. Or accountability. I need someone to hold me accountable along the process. Okay. And so clarity, simplicity, and accountability, which one of those do you really need to work on in this season? And where and how are you going to work on that to move forward in your health, right? And so I would love to help you. This is three things I'll have all my one-on-one clients with, and that I will help you in the More Than Your Weight 6-week boot camp that's coming up in August. You're like, Brandon, it's June. I'm not even thinking about August. Well, let me tell you why you should, because if you do register for this, pay a deposit, then you're going to get a one-on-one session with me where I'm going to give you clarity, accountability, and simplicity for you right now in the summer. I think the summer is a beautiful time to enjoy life, be with family, relax a little, but I think it's also a time to be a little bit more intentional when it comes to our health. There's a little bit more space. Brain space to think about it and space in your calendar. So all I ask for you to do is just book a clarity call with me at madewell345.com/clarity, madewell345.com/clarity, to figure out where we're going to talk and figure out if this program is a great fit for you. Book a time. I have some spots open, I think, on Friday. I have some spots open next Monday and next Friday as well. So please book a time so we can just see. It may not be a great fit, but you're not going to know unless we talk about it. And you can leave the session saying it's not a great fit. That's fine, but let's talk through. And maybe there's something else that is, and I could help you figure that out. Okay. So let me know before you go, what are of the three things, clarity, simplicity, and accountability, which one do you need in this season to move forward from feeling sick and tired? And how are you going to do that? And then three, book a call with me to see how I can help you in getting all three of those ingredients through my 6-week program or maybe something else. Okay. And if you're interested more about what I was talking about with feeling sick and tired in the podcast, listen to the podcast episode 172 on the More Than Your Weight podcast. All right. I'll talk to you later.